Lone Pine, California, September 24th, 1972. Now, there are good reasons why we should come to the conclusion that all knowledge in the ordinary sense is only probable knowledge and not certain knowledge and can never be certain knowledge. I refer to knowledge in the sense of both sense perception, where we have the well-known illusions in perception, and conceptual cognition, because these are dependent upon the principle of contradiction, the bifurcation or dichotomy that is essential to a process of manifestation, so that we know nothing in this world except in contrast to its opposite. Thus we could not cognize upness without contrast to downness, goodness without contrast to evil, and so on through all of the dualities. With the result that if we take any conception and treat it as an ontological ultimate, we have made a fundamental error. For there is the contradictory of that ultimate conception, which has as much truth value as the original conception. Hence, ultimate truth not only lies beyond sense perception, but beyond conceptual cognition. The third door, the door which I emphasize and call realization, also has evidence of a certain relativity in it. I do introduce something which corresponds to this in the conception of realization, a conception used by Sri Aurobindo quite independently of me, as a third mode of cognition that is not reducible either to sense perception or conceptual cognition. I have had experience of five of these, three of them that would qualify apparently as in conformity with Aurobindo's conception of mental realization, two of them that would seem to be transcendental. In part, they tended to confirm earlier preconceptions. In part, they added to it. And in part, they modified radically the thought or implication that grew out of an earlier realization. Thus the fourth realization, which led to what might be called the vestibule to nirvana, produced the strong feeling of the unreality of the whole manifested universe, that it was all a Maya, confirmed the Mayavadi point of view. Yet, after that, the fifth realization emphasized the principle of equilibrium and of a balance between the samsaric and nirvanic poles, introducing thus the conception of the equipotency between nirvana and samsara, a position which is maintained in the later phases of Buddhism, and that you cannot therefore affirm a higher reality of the nirvanic state than of the samsaric state, but that these two represent simply the highest of the dualities, and they are resolved in a still higher state, a still more transcendent state, which may well be that of para nirvana, which stands in a position of neutrality between the inconceivable bliss of nirvana and the suffering of samsara. Now, I introduce this in connection with our discussion of the subject of death for the reason that we do not have certainties concerning that which will follow the transition of this body. And it may well be that the problem of death is the very most fundamental basis for any religion whatsoever, because it is the problem that most, in the end, is our largest problem, the mystery of death. And a mystery we cannot avoid, and I therefore insist upon the dealing with this problem in an unemotional and rational spirit as part of the adventure before us. Typically, we avoid thinking about it. We will say, as a general proposition, since people have died in the past, it's probably true that I shall have the experience of death. In fact, there's a logical reason why you can say with even greater assurance that death has a certain inevitability. What we call that, at least, on the principle that anything that is the product of becoming is of necessity subject to the law of decay. Where there's birth, it must be balanced by the inverse movement. This is affirmed in Buddhism, but I think we can see it as necessary in a logical sense. What I'm suggesting is the willingness to dare upon probable truth and not insist upon certainty before taking a position. That's the best we have in science, and I'm submitting it is also the best we have in religion. We have an adventure before us,